How many of you know many of us wish we could make a fresh start? We wish we could turn the page and start again. You know what? In Christ, you can. I want us to look at the story of someone in the book of Joshua. And in this book of new beginnings, the first person we encounter as Joshua invades Jericho, the first city in Canaan, the first person we encounter is not a king who gets saved, not a good person who gets saved, not a priest who gets saved, but Rahab the harlot, a prosy, a escort. But there's a typecast of this person, a messed up life. The Bible says that Rahab was born to a noble family, but she chose a certain course. And God comes along and enters the life of this person, and she gets a fresh start. How many of you know if God can give someone like that a fresh start, you and I in this building can have a fresh start. Then Joshua, son of Nun, secretly sent two spies from Shittim. Circle the word two because it has incredible importance in Scripture. Go look over the land, he said, especially Jericho. So they went and entered the house of a prostitute named Rahab and stayed there. The king of Jericho was told, look, some of the Israelites have come here tonight to spy out the land. So the king of Jericho sent this message to Rahab, bring out the men who have come to you and entered your house because they have come to spy out the whole land. But the woman had taken the two men and hidden them. She said, yes, the men came to me, but I did not know where they had come from. At dusk, when it was time to close the city gate, they left. I don't know which way they went. Go after them quickly. You may catch up with them. But she had taken them up to the roof and hidden them under the stalks of flax. Before the spies lay down for the night, she went up on the roof. And she said to them, I know that the Lord has given you this land and that a great fear of you has fallen on us, so that all who live in this country are melting in fear because of you. For the Lord your God is God in heaven above and on earth below. How many of you know that's a confession of faith? She had a revelation. And verse 12, now then please swear to me by the Lord that you will show kindness to my family because I've shown kindness to you. Give me a sure sign that you will spare the lives of my father and mother, my brothers and sisters, and all who belong to them, and that you will save us from death. So she let them down by a rope through the window, for the house she lived in was part of the city wall. She said to them, go to the hills so the pursuers will not find you. Hide yourselves there 3 days until they return, then go on your way. Now the men had said to her, this oath you made us swear will not be binding on us unless when we enter the land, you have tied this scarlet cord in the window through which you let us down, and unless you have brought your father and mother, your brothers, and all your family into your house. I want you to underline two words, this before scarlet cord, because it wasn't just any scarlet cord, and house. She had to tie a scarlet cord on the window, on the windowsill, on the bars, wherever, and she had to stay in the house. The Old Testament has prophetic significance when it refers to these things, and we'll see it in a moment. So she sent them away, and they departed, and she tied the scarlet cord in the window. Now we come to daytime, and Joshua is invading Jericho. They march around it 7 times. The walls come down. But I want you to see something interesting here. Not all the walls come down. Joshua said to the two men who had spied out the land, go into the prostitute's house and bring her out and all who belong to her in accordance with your oath to her. So the young men who had done the spying went in and brought out Rahab, her father, mother, her brothers, sisters, and all who belonged to her. They brought out her entire family and put them in a place outside the camp of Israel. So she was preserved. The whole wall didn't collapse. Their house was safe because she stayed inside. Joshua spared Rahab the prostitute with her family and all who belonged to her because she hid the men Joshua sent as spies to Jericho, and she lives among the Israelites to this day. And I want to give you 5 fresh start principles from this passage this morning for broken lives and broken families. 5 fresh start principles. The first thing we need to understand about a fresh start is a fresh start often begins with a shake-up. A fresh start often begins with a shake-up. When this woman was about to make a fresh start, the walls of the city were shaken. The walls fell down in places. Her home must have been shaken. And God was preparing to shake off the old that he might bring the new. How many of you realize in your life sometimes when you're facing trouble, that trouble or that shake-up is not accidental? It's God actually shaking you to unsettle you, to get you to prepare, to get you to leave, to get you to move into a new season. Number two, the second thing is we must recognize our fresh start moments. We must recognize our fresh start moments. God sent two men to the house of Rahab. Those two spies in Scripture are not just a random figure. How many of you know the Father sent the Son into the world to die on a cross and to shed his blood? Are you with me? And the Holy Spirit was sent into the earth to confirm the believer. Well, here the Father sent the pre-incarnate Jesus, the one who always was, who appears in the Old Testament numerous times. We believe that this is the Son and the Holy Spirit entering this house, because the Son and the Holy Spirit bring salvation. And the Son comes and he tells her, tie this red cord, which is a picture of the blood. They painted the blood on the doorpost. They stayed in the house in the book of Exodus, and judgment went over them. In Exodus 14, you read about their new beginning, their fresh start. Now here, the Son is telling her, tie this cord. This cord, not just any piece of flax you've got on the roof. You might be in the clothing business, but you can't just use anything for salvation. It's that which he provides, his blood. Number three, the third thing is a fresh start requires a confession of faith and a need for grace. If you want to make a fresh start, you've got to make a confession. You've got to declare who God is. You've got to welcome them. She spoke to them, went up on the roof, said, I believe that your God is the God. I want to receive you into my home. I want to protect you. You've got to receive the Son and the Holy Spirit into your life. You've got to confess that you believe, and you've got to stay in the house. You've got to be needy enough to stay in the house. The house is a picture of the church. If you stay in the church and you take the Son into your life, into your house, guess what happens? You prepare yourself for a new start. I want to remind you, this woman didn't have to get her act together. They didn't say, if you get your act together and you change the way you dress, because man, those shoes and that dress are going to cause trouble in Israel. Then we can maybe put you at the back somewhere and we can like sneak you into the camp. And like, if you don't tell anyone you're a harlot, like maybe. She didn't have to do anything. It wasn't her works. It was not merit. It wasn't change of character. It was faith. And that's what it is today. If you want to change, you just say, Lord, I trust you. I take the Son. I take the Holy Ghost. I commit to follow you, Lord. Be amazed how you can make a new start. Listen to me today. Here's something interesting. The woman is not only rescued by the men and brought into the camp of Israel and made part of Israel's community. She marries one of the princes of Judah after living a life of sexual promiscuity. I mean, you know, it's not everyone who wants to marry you when you've been involved in that. But she marries Salmon, who the Bible says is a prince of Judah. So she's brought into nobility. Where once she was vilified, now she's dignified. Then, from this union with Salmon, she has a son called Boaz. Boaz marries Ruth. Ruth has a child called Obed. Obed has a child called Jesse. Jesse is the father of King David. And from the line of King David came the Lord Jesus. Go to the book of Matthew, and there you find only four women in the genealogy. Guess who finds herself there? Rahab the harlot. Talk about a fresh start. She expected something better.